Hello friends. So in the previous session, we have derived this particular equation, right? So we found out, we modeled the armature reaction and also we added this particular resistance component, and we found out that the armature reaction is modeled as a inductance, right? It was modeled as an inductance, which is called X. And then you also had the self-inductance of the machine, which was XA, and then the resistance of the winding, which is the RA value, and these three contributed in making the EA value, the internal generated voltage of the generator, not equal to the V phase, that means the terminal voltage of the generator. So these are the three contributing factors for that. And we wrote that X plus XA is equal to XS, which is called the synchronous reactance of the generator. So if you look at this diagram, this is the equation. Now if you model this into a circuit, you know that this, what I have written here, it is for a single phase, right? So this is for a single phase. This is for a single phase. Okay, this is for a single phase. Now, but usually synchronous generator are three phase generators. So let us have three phases, which are A1, A2 and A3. You can call it anything what you want. You can call it A, B, C, R, Y, B, anything. But I am just following the conventions used in the book. So it is A1, A2 and A3. Okay. So that means there will be three equations corresponding to this particular phase equation which I have written. All right. So I can write the three equations. V phase of A1, okay, is equal to EA1 minus J into IA1 into XS minus IA1 into RA. Okay. Now, assuming that the resistance in all the windings are same, so I can just replace it as RA itself. Okay. So this V phase, V phi of A2 will be equal to EA2 minus J into IA2 into XS minus IA2 into RA. Okay. This is the second phase equation. And this is the final third phase equation. So EA3 minus J into IA3 XS minus IA3 into RA. So these are the three phase equations for each phase. So this is for phase A1, this is for phase A2, and this is for phase A3. Okay. So let's draw the equivalent circuit corresponding to this. Now, as I have already told you, for any diagram, any machine, you are having a field circuit and you are having a armature circuit, right? So in this particular case, what you have seen, so this is your armature, for example, this is your armature. Okay. And you are having your field here. This is the rotor, which is the field. So here you are having some DC supply. Okay, this is how the machine is. You are having a DC supply. So we have to model that also. So this is your field circuit, for example. I'm just drawing the field circuit here. So what will be the field circuit? The field circuit, just like in the DC separately excited machine. So you are having a DC source. Okay, you are having an adjustable resistance. Okay, and then you are having the RF, which is the field winding resistance. And you are having the field winding inductance here. And you are having the field voltage, VF. And you are having the field current, IF. Okay, so this will not be there in three phases because this is a DC circuit, alright. So this is only one here. But this three, we can model into three different circuits. So this is the field circuit. And let us draw our armature circuit here. So this is going to be the armature circuit which I am going to draw. So first is the EA1. Okay, this is EA1. Okay, and then you are having your RA here, okay, and then you are having your XS, okay, you are having your XS, and this will be your V phase 1, V phi 1, okay, and this current will be IA1, okay, so this is for one phase, and for the next phase, we have to draw EA2, okay, very simple, this is EA2, which is corresponding to this particular equation, so you are having your RA, okay, and then you are having your XS, and then here you are having your V phi 2, and then the third phase you are going to have your EA3, alright, and then you are having your RA, and then you are having your XS, and here you are having your V phase 3, okay, and this is IA1 here, which is flowing to the first phase. The second phase you are having IA2, and in the third phase you are having IA3. Okay, so this is the important thing here. And now EA1, EA2 and EA3 are separated. How many degrees in phase? 120 degree in phase. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit which I have drawn here. I'll just put it in a red box. So this is the three phase equivalent circuit. All right. So this is the three phase equivalent circuit. Three phase equivalent circuit of a synchronous generator. But usually, before that, let us just draw. Now, because it's a three phase connection, right? It's a three phase connection. So this three phase can be connected in two ways, right? It can be connected either in star or it can be connected in delta. Okay, that means the generator, the three phases can be connected in either star or in delta. So let us see first the star connection. Okay, so this is going to be the star connection. So you are going to have your voltages connected in star. So let me just draw it quickly. So this is your R, this is your XS, R, and this is going to be your R, and this is going to be your XS. Okay, so you have to, what is the star connection? The common points are connected together. So either the positive or the negatives are connected. So I am going to connect the negatives together. So this is the star connection. Okay, so this is your EA1, and this is your EA2, and this is your EA3. Okay, just, and I'll just put the alternating current symbol. This is RA, XS, RA, XS, RA, and XS. And this is going to feed some load here. So these are going to feed some loads here. So what all can I write here? So I can mark this is the load current IL. Here I will have some phase currents, right? So I can just write this is the phase current IA. Okay, and the voltage between this point and this particular point is the phase voltage. Okay, the voltage between one phase is the phase voltage. So here you are having a V5. Okay, this can be your V5 1, and this can be your V5 2, and this can be your V5 3. Okay, now if assuming that it's a perfectly balanced system, you can just write everything as to be V5. Okay, so I'll just remove that now. So let everything be just V5, so that the diagram does not get cluttered much. Okay, so you're having all these values here. Now the value, for example, this is your A1, right? A3, and this is your A2. So the voltage between A1 and A2, remember, this V5 is between A1 and a common point. So if I connect it to a neutral, this V5 was between A1 and the neutral. But what is the voltage between A1 and A2? It is called the line voltage, right? The voltages between two phases are called the line voltage. So this is VL. And what will be this VL value equal to for a star connection? It will be root 3 into V phase. Okay, so here it is internal generated voltage EA1 that comes out from the phase as V5, and that V5 in a star connection, in line voltage, it is root 3 into V phase. Okay, so in this case it will be root 3 into V phase. So this is the star connection. So now let us look at the delta connection now very quickly. So this is the delta connection. So let us just draw it very fast. So this is your one voltage source, and this is your second voltage source, and here you are having your third voltage source. Okay, and this is going to connect to the load. All right, so in delta connection, it is an end-to-end connection, plus to minus, minus to plus. So here you are having plus, and so here I can put a minus, and here I can put a minus plus here. Okay, so this valve can be EA1, EA2, and this is EA3. So EA1 leads EA2, EA2 leads EA3. So it is a three phase connection which is 120 degree displaced. So this is RA, XS, RA, XS, RA, and XS. Okay, so in this case, this will be the line current. Alright, this is the line current, and however, the phase current is not equal to the line current in a delta connection. In the star connection, the phase current was equal to the line current, right? So if I just put the value IA here, okay, and in a delta connection, you can clearly see the voltage between two phases. Okay, this is A1, A2, A3. The voltage between two phases, A1 and A2, is same as the phase voltage. Okay, so here this is VL, which is equal to V5. Okay, so if this voltage is V5, VL is equal to V5, but IL will be equal to root 3 times of I phase. So in this case, the phase current is IA. So it is root 3 into IA. Alright, so VT or VL is equal to, So VT is equal to V phase and IL is equal to root 3 times into IA. Now drawing all these things continuously in three phases is a bit difficult. So what we have is a per phase equivalent. Okay, per phase equivalent. This is very important in power systems. So you have a per phase equivalent diagram. So per phase equivalent means if the loads are perfectly balanced, okay, that means you can replace the three phase diagram into a per phase diagram. That means a single phase diagram. So how does a single phase diagram look like? So this is the field circuit. Okay, so you are having your R adjustable here to control the field current. Then you are having the field winding resistance, field winding inductance LF. This is the field winding voltage VF, field winding current IF. Okay, so in the armature circuit you had three phases, but now you can replace it by a single phase value. So this is EA and this is your RA, this is your XS and this can be your V5. Okay, and this is your IA. So this is the per phase equivalent of a synchronous generator. So this is the equivalent circuit of a synchronous generator in per phase value. So usually it is this diagram which is used because drawing the three phase diagrams every time is a bit difficult, but provided it can be used only if the loads are perfectly balanced. So with this particular session, we are concluding the equivalent circuit of the synchronous generator. In the next session onwards, we'll start with the phasor diagram of the synchronous generator. So I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe the channel if you have liked this video. Don't forget to watch the AC machinery fundamentals, the DC machines course and also the engineering circuit analysis course, which is in the playlist of the same channel. All right, and also you can check out the notes in the WordPress page, which also you will find in the page of my YouTube channel. And till I meet you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off and have a great day. Thank you.